the ECW Television Champion. Powerbomb! Great elevation! Malenko goes for the Boston Crab. Guerrero on top. 1-2 now. Guerrero now. Hooks the legs of Malenko. Takes Malenko over. Caught wheel by Guerrero. Here are clotheslines. And it's frightening how evenly matched these two athletes are. In the tradition of Dory Funk Jr. versus Jack Briscoe, Vern Gagne versus Billy Robinson, Ric Flair versus Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, a classic wrestling feud has developed here in Extreme Championship Wrestling between Television Champion Eddie Guerrero and the Shooter Dean Malenko. Recently, over the course of 2 days, in three different cities, the Malenko-Guerrero Classic took place. It was documented on ECW Fan Cam, and you can own it by calling 1-800-357-8393. But right now, we'll see highlights from the matchup that led to the Classic, the rematch between Guerrero and Malenko. And I was joined for this matchup by a very special color commentator.
Television Champion Eddie Guerrero readies himself to once again defend that title belt against the Shooter Dean Malenko, and to make the call on this all-important matchup, I have requested a very special color commentator, a world-class athlete, both in the amateur and professional ranks, to join me and lend his expertise to what should be a classic rematch between Eddie Guerrero and the Shooter Dean Malenko. A former amateur and collegiate wrestling champion, a man quite familiar with the discipline of judo, I am joined by Peter Sinosha. A man whose credentials certainly speak for themselves, and a man whose insight into this title matchup will be most valuable. Thank you for joining me in the broadcast position.
I'm here to do commentary. That's what I'm going to give you.
Intense, emotionless. Quite simply, Malenko wants what he believes to be his title back.
205 pounds, the current ECW Television Champion, Eddie Guerrero!
A world-class athlete who has made his mark on Extreme Championship Wrestling. There's the bell. We are ready for action. The two circle one another. They lock up. Guerrero goes behind Malenko with the full Nelson. And now Guerrero with the hammerlock. Guerrero takes down Malenko, although I'm not sure what type of takedown that was. Perhaps you can...
It was like a Mexican type of an arm drag, like a tight rolling. What he's got on here now is a Fujiwara arm bar. Very rough submission hold. Malenko's grabbing his own hand to avoid Guerrero to snap that elbow.
At the same time, referee John Finnegan making sure Malenko's shoulders were on the mat. They were for just a split second. Malenko now.
He's going for a leg lace, or grapevine, as some people in the pro wrestling world call it. He's got it.
Applying pressure to both the knees and the lower back, I would believe, of Eddie Guerrero. Guerrero trying to reach back and hook the chin of Malenko.
Something you never want to do. You never want to reach back like that. Guerrero's phenomenal, but you never want to reach back. You have no leverage.
as you pointed out, that lack of leverage aided Malenko in keeping the hold. Pair of knees to the hamstring, Guerrero shot in hard, clothesline followed in by Malenko. Guerrero now set the other way up to the second turnbuckle. Malenko, Guerrero exchanging punches, and a flying head scissors of sorts from the top. Malenko clutching the back of his head.
Well, he popped off the dragon sleeper. Tatsumi Fujinami had to teach Malenko that. We're 15 seconds away from seeing Guerrero get choked out.
As is evident by the fact that Guerrero flailed like a fish out of water, panicking, trying to get to the bottom rope. He did. The hold has been broken. And Guerrero may have barely escaped, as you said, losing that television title to the shooter. Guerrero throws to the outside. Malenko rolls out after him. Kicks Guerrero in the midsection. Guerrero sent into the steel guardrail. Malenko now stalking the TV champion. Guerrero throwing back in, Malenko right in after him.
That's the Tiger Bomb. There it is. Tiger Bomb, Joey.
One, two, and up. Guerrero barely escapes the Tiger Bomb. And Malenko now showing signs of frustration, wondering what will it take to put Guerrero away and take the television title. His feet. Malenko now standing on the throne of Guerrero, pulling on the rope for extra leverage. And the television title is in serious jeopardy right now. Belly to back suplex with a forward. Cover, one, two, and now. Guerrero somehow, from somewhere, musters the strength to get that shoulder up. And Malenko again is wondering, what will it take to put Guerrero away? Tombstone pile driver coming up, perhaps. He hits. Guerrero is spiked. One, two, and now. Again, Guerrero gets the shoulder up. Where is he getting the strength from?
I don't know, but every vertebra in his spine had a snap on that pile driver.
Indeed, Malenko has target to the back of Guerrero. He has not let up. He has been unrelenting and merciless in his attack on Guerrero's back. Guerrero now set up on the top turnbuckle. Malenko goes downstairs a second time. Thumb to the eye by Guerrero. Here comes his DDT. No! Shot off by Malenko. Guerrero soars through the air like a frisbee. And Malenko seems to be a step ahead of Guerrero. But a count away from becoming the ECW Television Champion. Powerbomb! Great elevation! Malenko goes for the Boston Crab. Guerrero on top. One, two, now! Guerrero now! Hooks the legs of Malenko. Takes Malenko over. Caught wheel by Guerrero. Here are clotheslines! And it's frightening how evenly matched these two athletes are. They go to the outside.
Malenko is sent to the guardrail. Guerrero is sending to the top turnbuckle. We've seen this before. Oh my God! Vertical suplex. No, oh, brainbuster.
He held him up in the air to get that blood rushing through his skull and dumped him right on his head. I love it.
And while you may, Malenko certainly does it. Of course, no love lost between you and Malenko. Guerrero sent to the top turnbuckle. Goes for the frog splash, but Malenko brings the knees up. Malenko really scouted Guerrero, knows that he and his late partner, Love Machine Art Barr, both world famous for that frog splash. But Malenko able to bring the knees up, and Guerrero now in serious jeopardy on the outside. Guerrero thrown back in. Malenko knows he can only win this match in the ring. And now Malenko is setting to the top turnbuckle. We don't see it too often. And that may be the reason why. Guerrero already up there with them. Both men up top. Superplex. And that may have taken just as much out of Guerrero as it did from Malenko. Both men now running on fumes. The tanks may be empty. Fingers to the eye. Guerrero up top. Where's he going? He's walking the tightrope. Into a Frankensteiner. One, two, and now!
He landed right on his head, Joey. Guerrero dumped himself on his head. Might have busted open his eye or the back of his head. It looks like being the back of his head.
Oh, correct. I hadn't even noticed that.
Yeah, the blood's gushing to the front, but it really cracked open the back.
That seems to be the case. Guerrero is going for that Frankensteiner, landed on the back of his head, and busted himself wide open.
A lot of people don't realize that that mat, that canvas is like leather. It's like a knife when your head lands on it. Malenko can capitalize on this. This match is over.
And Malenko would once again be the television champion. A thought which I'm sure does not thrill you in. What's Malenko doing right now?
He's checking out the injury, Joey. He's looking to see what he can capitalize on. He's actually looking where the cut and the blood is coming from. This guy is vicious.
Like a bird of prey.
Yeah, there it goes. He found it and he planted his elbow in it.
Measured Guerrero. And as you said, planted that elbow with pinpoint accuracy. There's a two count. And Guerrero somehow gets the shoulder up. Referee John Finnegan checking Guerrero. Deemed he can continue. This is indeed Extreme Championship Wrestling.
Malenko, what Guerrero might want to do is keep that blood out of his eye. That blood gets in the eye, you can't see. It tears up your eye, you're blinded. And you don't want to be blinded with the shooter in there. He's going for that Texas cloverleaf.
Small package, two and no!
That Texas cloverleaf, the hold that Dean Malenko made very famous. In Japan, his father, Professor Boris Malenko, taught it to him as a young boy. It's a dangerous, vicious leg lock.
Guerrero up on his feet. Malenko is as well. Malenko throws it to the corner. Malenko now set up on the top turnbuckle. Guerrero goes right up after him. Frankensteiner from the top! One, two, and no! Powerbomb by Guerrero.
Advantage Malenko.
Far be it for me to question your expertise, but how is that Malenko's advantage?
It's simple, man. He took every shot Guerrero could dish out. He kicked out of all his covers. Besides that, he's working on that gash in the back of his head. The way I see it, Guerrero's got a face full of blood. And Dean just got some sweat on his head. Guerrero's in trouble, man.
And Malenko stalking Guerrero. Guerrero almost limp.
Malenko now rolls up Guerrero, bridges, two and none. Guerrero shot in once again. Well-placed Nino gets rolled up, two and none.
I don't know where he got that schoolboy from, but at Guerrero, he took that knee and then rolled him up with that schoolboy. That was amazing.
Guerrero now on top of Malenko. Takes Malenko over, one, two, and now! Malenko somehow gets his shoulders off the mat. Malenko retreating into the corner. Guerrero comes right down across the solar plexus and the ribs of Malenko with all 205 pounds, dragging Malenko to the center of the ring. And locks in the figure four. There's the bell. What happened? Did the shooter tap out? What's the referee's decision? What's the call? Again?
Still your ECW Television Champion!
Another classic matchup, another 30-minute time limit draw between Eddie Guerrero and the shooter Dean Malenko. And the battle for the ECW Television title continues.